The Uganda Microfinance Regulatory Authority and Postbank have signed a memorandum of understanding aimed at digitizing the operations of savings groups and bring more people into the money economy. Through the partnership, the two entities are seeking to leverage on WND, a Postbank's mobile digital wallet, to digitize operations of regulated Tier 4 financial institutions and informal savings groups across the country.
And today, the reason for WND is to call on all the licensees to embrace the WND wallet, to embrace this digital platform, which will now extend service to them. This all moves these 2,000 institutions that have been regulated here at UMRA to move into the digital space, and it will take our country into very huge mileage that we shall have achieved.
So for us to say that we are fostering prosperity for Ugandans, we need to start with where the people get into the money system. And that's at the bottom of the pyramid. And that's why UMRA is too critical for us to collaborate with them. I'll give you an example. If a SACCO came here to register, how will they collect the money? They are going either to meet on a weekly basis or monthly basis, and they are going to put together money. They can put it in a briefcase like what Ibra said. And what we are saying is that
the recent 2023 FinScope survey revealed a sharp increase in the adoption of SACCOs and mobile money services in Uganda since 2018. SACCO usage rose from 5% in 2018 to 15% in 2023, while mobile money usage jumped from 23% to 42% over the same period. Despite this growth, many Ugandans still store money at home, signaling a lack of confidence in both formal and informal financial service providers. It's such parameters that the partnership seeks to change over the next 5 years.
At the end of 2028, we shall conduct a review of whether the strategy was implemented, and one of the parameters to measure financial inclusion levels, the number of adults that are financially included, the increase in household incomes. So we shall be looking at those levels, and we believe they will increase because instead of having information that is not, the data set which is not included on the WND platform, we are looking at the bottom pyramid population. We have not been having that data and the access. This time around, we shall have a wallet where we shall access that data.
Bringing more people into the money economy has been one of the key government deliverables in the recent years, with the introduction of socio-economic programs like parish development model to be benefiting and previously underserved groups. In the end, this is expected to have an impact on the interest rates.
The exorbitant interest rates. We are trying so much as UMRA to support the system by making sure that we have the information that is required, and there is no reason for people to be charged so exorbitant interest rates. So while we are here today to do this launch of the WND wallet, we are also trying to say, if somebody is already on WND, why do you charge them so highly? Because you will be using all these different platforms to know them very well. And if you know them, why do you extend service at such a high rate?
The organizations are now expected to roll out across the country to rally different savings groups to embrace the digital wallet.